Hi, I'm Peach Milk, and I'm going to show you how I made the song on the Deluge. And straight away we're in our track view mode. So we've got a brand new empty track here. You can select between either synth or kit. In this case we'll go with kit. And then over on the audition pads you can listen to and scroll through different presets, different kits. Also we'll just program in a basic beat, gimmeth. Cool. And then what I'm going to do is duplicate that, so we'll have it twice as long. So if you just press down on shift and then press down on this knob on the horizontal scroll, now we've got a duplicate, so our sequence is twice as long. In doing that, it zooms you right out so you can see your entire sequence. So to zoom back in, we press down on the horizontal knob and just twist it. Then it'll show you what note value you're working in. So we scroll along, we can see our different sequence. Cool, so just program a few notes in here and there to begin with, and we can always come back and add some more later. Cool, so we'll just leave it at that now. If we go back into song mode, we can see our drum sequence there, or our drum track. Now to make a new track, we just click on an empty row. So we'll go in here, make a bass line, and we're in synth. So now we can scroll through and find something to use for a bass line. So maybe we'll go with this. You can also go into keyboard mode. I'm just gonna stay in this mode, in the sequencer mode for now though. Cool, and then if you want to scroll down, you can go down octaves as well. Might just start with something simple like that. So if we zoom out, you can see our entire sequence. You can see that that's going to be a little bit short for the bass line. So if I just press shift and scroll along, and add, as you see, more of the grayed out squares become usable, then it's basically lengthening your track. Cool, so now if we zoom right out, cool, looks pretty good. So if we hit record, and we'll just wait for it to cycle to the beginning. Back into our drum track. down while adjusting the parameter. Let go. You can hear the delay there. Maybe I add a little bit more. Cool. Maybe a little bit less. But yeah, as long as you're holding it down, you can adjust any of those parameters. Back into song view, and what we'll do is make a clone of our bass line and just do a variation on it. So to make a clone, you just hold down whatever track you'd like to duplicate and then press on an empty row, and as you can see, it's just made a duplicate of our bass line. So I'll just launch that one. Do is keep the first bar the same and then make a variation on the second. So we shift and duplicate that, zoom back in, go to our second bar, and now we'll make a change. You can always audition your notes to figure out what you want to play, or you can record it as well, obviously. Take it out of scale mode so we can view our semitones. And we'll go down a semitone for that note. Cool. So the next thing you might want to do to add a bit of spice to your bass line is recording some automation. Track, but we'll just do that for the bass line. So we hit record and then adjust a parameter, it'll record it for the entire sequence. Drum track and our two bass lines. So we can just switch between those and have a listen. Cool, so I might just leave that one playing for now. We'll start a new track and maybe add a synth pad. Thank you. adjust one of the reverb parameters, so you can actually access those using a shift control. So if you go shift, and then over here we've got the room size, so I'm going to make that room size a bit bigger. Thank you. adjust the sound slightly so you can get a bit more of a difference between the two chords. And then what I'll do is add another bar to this. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to adjust and randomize the frequency and resonance. Cool. So if I just go shift and hit frequency, currently it says off. If I scroll backward, got some different values. You can kind of set that to whatever you want, and we'll just go with 40 for now. And then we'll shift and hit random down here. Randomizing the frequency for every note. Do that, and then we're going to do the same for resonance. So we just hit back, shift, go resonance, and we'll do the same thing. So we'll go around there, shift, and hit random, and now do that. Some quite interesting little blippy textural kind of sounds. Maybe we'll do that. Adjust some of these parameters. This one is reducing the sample rate, so now we've got some kind of blippy, lo-fi, almost Game Boy-esque sounds. That we'll implement is just doing a variation on our drums. So we can go up and clone that drum track, launch it, go in and make some changes. collection of samples over here. I quite like that. So if you just hit it once, we'll program in one note. In the sample mode that we're in right now, it's going to play for the entirety of the sample.